You're welcome. Okay.
Yeah.
Hi.
Hi.
How are you?
Wow. With that smile, I can safely say I'm not as good as you. What's going on?
Well, for once, I can say that everything in my life is perfect.
That's a pretty strong statement. Perfect?
Mm-hmm. I have everything I've ever wanted. And you know what? It feels great.
Every single thing?
Yep.
Whatever you're doing, it must be working.
It sure is. And I'm going to make sure it keeps working.
Well, what it comes down to is Catherine just felt like she never really measured up.
Because she was the cook's daughter?
Well, her mother worked hard, but they were employees, you know, and growing up on a big estate like that, Catherine just always compared herself to Dominique.
So she pretended to be Dominique's friend?
No, that was really true. They were good friends.
Oh, maybe.
Oh, come on, for crying out loud. Listen, you saw pictures of them as little girls together, playing mud pies and cutting out paper dolls. But as she got older, she just felt like an outsider.
Doesn't your heart just bleed for her? Do you believe he's fallen for this?
Will you shut up?
No! What is wrong with you, for God's sakes? What is wrong with you? That woman has lied to you since day one, and you've now swallowed this latest sob story without even gagging.
You're like a broken record. I mean, don't you ever get tired of bad-mouthing Catherine?
And don't you get tired of defending her?
Oh, come on, you guys. This bickering is giving me a headache.
I know what you mean here. She's just so negative always.
Well, it turned out I had reasons to be suspicious, didn't it?
I swear, one more word against her.
Oh, go ahead. Okay, go ahead. Just stick your head in the sand. You know, Catherine, whatever her name is, did lie to you. Not once, but repeatedly.
You may have a point, Scott.
Thank you,
well,
Julia.
Then you should comb your hair differently. She did not lie to me repeatedly. The only thing she lied about was her name. Bad habit, Lucy. I swear I will. I swear. And if you think I'm kidding around here, you're sadly mistaken. Ah.
You know, I like the area that she added over here. It's really a good use of dead space.
Come in.
Catherine. Sorry to interrupt.
What do you want?
I realize you may not want to talk to me right now, but I'd really like a chance to explain.
This
might not be a good time, Catherine. I'm sure that Scott and Lucy told you that I'm not Catherine Crawford. I imagine that came as a shock to you.
You could say that.
Well, I do feel awful about it.
Oh, gee, don't. You know, the real Catherine Crawford was very nice.
Dominique was my friend, Julia, and everything I told you was true.
I'd like to think so.
Well, I can understand if you're angry.
Look, Catherine, I don't care what your name is. I really don't. Dominique was my friend, my best friend.
I know that.
And when I thought that you were lying about growing up with Dominique and about being close to her, I did feel used.
Well, if it makes a difference, I do feel very ashamed.
About using a different name, well, then why do you do it? We befriended you. Scott loaned you money to pay off your husband's debt. We gave you a job.
And people call me ungrateful.
You were wonderful. No one has ever shown me such kindness.
And why couldn't you level with me?
Julia, you grew up in a different world. You have no idea what it was like to have nothing, to feel like a charity case. You know, all my clothes were Dominique's hand-me-downs. I never had anything new or anything to call my own.
Why are you listening to this?
Because I am trying to understand. Do you mind?
Excuse me.
Catherine, please. Go on. Well, Dominique had beautiful things, right? I should have been happy to have them.
But you weren't?
Well, Dominique was great about it. But the kids used to tease because they'd recognize her blouse or her sweater. A lot of them were monogrammed. I remember I'd sit up at night picking out the little stitches. But you could still see the initials. It sounds so silly now, I know, but at the time when I was trying so hard to fit in, everybody's teasing really hurt. I was happiest when I was pretending to be somebody else. So when I grew up and I left Serenity, I decided that I would become a different person. I became the person I wanted to be.
I'm surprised you didn't just use the name of Dominique Stanton.
I wouldn't do that.
Just checking for boundaries.
I should have been honest with you and Scott. I realize that. I mean, the two of you deserve that more than anybody. I wouldn't blame you if you'd like to fire me right now and never see me again. I have to admit, that was my first inclination. But that's not what I want. I don't care what your last name is, Catherine. I like you. Do you really mean that?
Yes.
Let's just move on. Come on. I'll walk you out.
Great.
Like I'm in a Stephen King movie, Revenge of the Pod People. I'm the only one with a brain left around here.
Oh, please, can you just stop this?
I used to think that you were very smart, but now you're getting as bad as Scott.
Why? Because I have a little compassion?
Because, Julia, you've been had.
Lucy, you haven't liked Catherine from the moment you laid eyes on her.
Guilty.
So why should I listen to you? Look, I don't know what your agenda is with Scott. Frankly, I don't think you know. But obviously, you don't want him to have anything to do with Catherine.
Because she is no good for him.
Don't you think that should be his call?
No. His judgment is clouded. She's cast some sort of spell on him or something.
Oh, she misled him about her name, and she feels awful about it.
Oh, my. You bought that pitiful pearl act, too, didn't you?
Okay. One more time. And that's all I'm going to give you. So you'd better pay attention, because after that, you're going to be on your own. Now, listen to me. If you keep going after her, you're going to alienate Scott, and then the only connection you're going to have to him is that baby you're carrying.
Hi. Goodbye. Jenny's new designs?
Mm-hmm.
They look good?
Yep, they're inspired. Listen, do you have some time? Because we have some things we need to go over.
What things?
Hotel things.
Oh. Well, they'll just have to wait till tomorrow. Because I have other plans this evening.
Fine. We'll talk tomorrow. Huh. What do you think?
The plans?
Uh-huh.
Ah, they're terrific.
So do I.
It's a big improvement.
AJ, come on.
You know, I've got some hotel business for myself that I want to discuss with you.
Such as?
Don't you think we could find some place a little more private where maybe we wouldn't be disturbed? Mm-hmm.
We're all alone. How much privacy do you need?
For what I've got in mind?
Mm-hmm.
Lots.
Hotel business, my foot.
You know, the spa isn't that crowded right now. We could take one of the massage booths and,
what?
Give you a massage. What else?
Oh. Well, as delightful as that sounds, I've got a pass.
But you don't know what you're missing.
I have much too much work to do.
Yeah, but don't you realize that the more relaxed you are, the more work you can get done?
Yeah. Is that right?
Yeah, oh God, you're so tense.
Ow.
Yeah, your muscles are, they're all in knots here. What are you going to do about this?
It almost feels like you know what you're doing. Mm.
You know, it'd be a lot better if we take this off.
Hey, Jane. Oh, that is.
Thank you.
You're wonderful.
Even like this?
Hey, have you seen Lucy?
Checking
you off.
Well,
hi.
Hi. I interrupted you guys?
No, it's okay.
No, I was just leaving. Listen, I'll get back to you about that matter as soon as I can, okay?
Thank you. I would appreciate it, AJ.
Okay, AJ. See Lucy?
No, she's probably off pouting somewhere.
Yeah, because of Catherine. Why do I let that girl get to me?
Look, it's not just you. Lucy can be relentless.
Yeah, I know, but, you know, I... You were here, I was in here yelling at her. I mean, I shouldn't have been doing that.
Well, you were angry. Angry people yell.
I hate it when she goes off on Catherine like that. I mean, I know that she's, you know, she thinks she's right and everything.
And... You know, and she just can't help herself.
No, she can't. I don't have to tell you our past history. I mean, most of the time I'm with Lucy, I always want to just... strangle her, you know?
I can understand that feeling, yeah.
But, you know, still, we've stayed great friends here. Dominique saw the good in Lucy, and then she got me to see it, and she was right. And, you know, here she is, you know, carrying a child for us, you know, all these months.
It's pretty terrific.
Well, yeah, I mean, I don't know a lot of people that would have done that. I really don't.
Hey.
Lucy wanted to do it.
Yeah, what do? You know, I threatened to cut her out of my life once the baby is born. I mean, that was pretty stupid. So, you know, I've been feeling the baby kick a lot.
Oh, that's pretty exciting, huh?
Well, and we go to the doctor. Next time, I'm going to hear the heartbeat again. Amazing. That's very, very close to me being a father. Very close.
You're going to be a wonderful father.
Do you think so? Do you really think so? What was that?
I don't know. Gosh, what was that?
Lucy!
Oh, my God! I'll get an ambulance.
Lucy! Lucy, wake up. Lucy.
Okay,
Julia, hurry up.
Uh-huh. At the Port Charles.
Are you okay?
Hotel,
what's going on?
Down,
yeah,
right.
Yeah, it's me.
In the spa.
Are you all right? What happened?
Well, she seems.
I don't know.
Wait, don't try to sit up. Everything's all right. Just relax, all right?
Well, I was walking to the office and I heard you. And
they
Julia, and then I had this terrible pain across
my
abdomen,
right
here.
Was the pain
and
down here?
And everything went black, and I just...
No, is it all right? No, wait, don't try and move. Just,
I don't know.
Something happened here.
No, there's one on the way.
Scott.
I know.
Scott,
just take it easy.
Are you there?
Yes, I'm here. Where's
don't
the pain?
Don't move.
Do you feel the pain?
Yes, it's right there.
Right here.
Is it still?
Oh,
no. Wait a minute. Is it the baby?
I don't know.
You don't know? Wait.
Scott.
Just calm down. Just don't think about it. Just here.
Help is on the way.
It's coming. We're gonna go. We're gonna get you to the hospital. Just calm down.